I went and got a haircut on Tuesday.
Pretty standard stuff.
Tuesday. Shout out to Bubs, Old Bank, Old Market. He is my barber. I go to him exclusively. I had to wait. Multiple people.
Worth the wait.
And yeah, I've gotten a lot of compliments on the haircut. But as I'm sitting in the chair, he said this to me multiple times over the last few times I've gotten a haircut. He goes, man, he goes, that dent in your hair is getting worse.
Wait, what?
I go, I know. He goes, I say I got to wear headphones. He goes, yeah. He goes, I know you worked this morning and you had your headphones on. He goes, but you got that dent in your hair. And I thought about it and I said to him, I go, well, when I sleep, I also wear a CPAP machine, which is a whole big headgear type thing.
Yeah.
So at night, for 7 hours, I have something that goes across the top of my head. And then when I'm in here, I have something that goes across the top of my head.
Uh-huh.
And it has now caused like a dent in my hair. So I'm trying to like loosen up my headphones and not wear them so tight. But it freaked me out. So I mentioned this on the air yesterday about how, you know, this job and these headphones have altered me now. And when we shaved your head,
I had a dent in it. My skull, my soft Southern Maryland.
There's a dent across the top of your head.
Trailer
from your
brain.
Headphones.
I have a dent. You could, Mike. You could run your finger, Mike. Run your finger across my skull. Go ahead.
Run your finger across his skull, Mike.
Right where the hair dent is. Run your finger.
It's the actual head.
The skull.
The
is,
skull, like a baby.
You don't remember when we shaved his head? We shaved his head, and you could see a dent in his head.
And that's from the headphones.
It's directly where my headphones are because I wear them real snug.
And that, can you fix that?
I don't know.
But that's what we're getting into because we brought this up yesterday, and I'm sitting here like a dumb idiot complaining about my hair being dented, which maybe my skull is too. I'll never know because I'm not shaving my head, but. The phone lines and the texts just flooded in of people that now have physical deformations or have physically changed because of work.
There was
things
a lot
they
of
have
people.
To wear, positions they sit in,
yes,
repetitive movements
repetitive
that they
movements,
have to
the
do.
Big one. The repetitive motion over and over is the big one.
I was blown away. I felt like an idiot complaining about hair when you got a guy who says, you know, he works a jackhammer all day and whatever. It's just...
Both of his rotator cuffs are permanently destroyed. His shoulders are screwed up. We had a guy, I'm trying to find the comment. You can go to Twitter, you can go to Facebook. There was a thread up there that got started. There was a guy whose wife called him the scoop because his hand was permanently in a scoop shape from holding on to the wheel of the truck that he drove as a cross-country driver. Says he can no longer extend his fingers fully at rest. His hand at rest snaps into a scoop.
Oh,
we had the princess, that smoking hot slice from medieval times. She's got a dent in her forehead, like a little divot, where the tiara rests. Just from wearing a tiara, it's permanently inside of there. And where's our buddy, Awesome Rob? Awesome Rob says that his right thumb was indented at the knuckle from playing 20 years of clarinet. 4 years after he stopped playing, it was still there, yet somehow semi-permanent. He still sees the dent in his thumb from playing clarinet in a traveling circus. I guess he had a clarinet job somewhere. Worked for a clarinet company. Here's some other ones here. Trish asked, my job has stolen my soul and will to live. Does that count? I'll take it. Here's one. God, sweet. Okay, I'm just going to call you Jacob. I'm going to call her Jacob, worked for a beer distributor for so long and had to sample so many beers, she now cannot get the weight off from working there. She was in great shape before she started, and now she has a permanent beer belly from working in the beer distribution industry.
I'm just going through the text.
Reading. No, here's another one. Shout out to our friends in the services, in the Corps. Wayne says the Corps and my time in there ground my joints into oblivion. All my joints are now bone on bone.
Yeah, we got some texters checking in about my situation, and shout out to the texter. I'll read your text, even though you felt the need to call me a pussy for
always
some reason.
Feels good.
He's suggesting earbuds, and I may switch to earbuds, but I tried earbuds on yesterday, I guess the day after I got the haircut. It's like, I can't have a dent in my hair.
Yeah, yeah.
So I got to wear, and I couldn't do it. They didn't sound right. So it's, when you have headphones on and they don't sound right, it can be very, very distracting.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, Richard, Army Field Artillery. My ears haven't stopped ringing since 2000. 18 years later, from out there, preparing the weapons of justice and freedom. Now his ears have a permanent ring to them. Oh, this is... Oh, I wish you could unlock your account, my sweet. Alphonse, she's a violin player. There's something known as the violin hickey. Look at that. It's from the violin resting on her neck.
Oh, my God.
She's got the permanent hickey on her neck. Oh, my God. That's crazy. Our friend Becky, sweet Becky, we sent her out to see Smashing Pumpkins, the queen of the Chick-fil-A. She says she has trouble hearing out of her right ear from so many years in the drive-thru wearing the headset.
Oh, dang.
From people just screaming into,
I like number one, I don't want any pickles. I can't have pickles. This is where you can please have pickles.
It's in her ear forever. She can't hear properly out of that ear.
Somebody says that you might have a soft skull disorder.
There's a good chance.
A dent in your skull.
Yeah, like a baby.
From your headphones.
I'm an infant with a beard. I mean, if you saw my penis, you'd lead me to believe that I'm an infant. It's very petite.
Being right-handed and working at a desk for 16 years from leaning on my right arm, my right shoulder now sits higher than my left shoulder. I'm only 27, but I have dents in my shins from climbing stepladders every day. A guy I work with has been running a manual lathe so long that he's developed a hunchback.
Oh, from being hunched over that thing.
Hunched over a lathe all day that now he has a hunchback.
Oh, Bobby Tropicana. We know our buddy Mr. Grove. Bobby Tropicana says he's got permanent raccoon eyes from the goggles that he has to wear on the construction site.
Damn.
The sun has bleached the skin underneath of it versus the skin underneath of the goggles themselves. So he's got raccoon eyes now. It's just changed him.
Have to wear earplugs and a dust mask every day at work. I have scar tissue inside my ears from the skin getting sore and peeling off. I had almost a bald patch on the top of my head from the thick rubber band strap and an indent on my neck. I've started wrapping the straps in paper towels to help.
Damn. And we're talking about like repetitive motions, not necessarily injuries. Yes, of course your leg looks completely different after somebody accidentally dropped a player piano onto the damn thing.
We're not. I got a lot of injuries, but we're going just more like just from doing something so long that
the lathe
you have
guy.
A weird, like a hunchback.
The lathe guy is exactly that, just people hunched over. And of years of walking around on hard cement floors constantly, my legs and feet permanently tingle. I can't get it to stop. And there was another one here I wanted to read before we jump to the phones. 410-338-1098. Our buddy Will, my left side of my back has knots from doing floor installation. When I was 18, I thought I was having a heart attack. I pulled the muscles so badly, so regularly in my chest from reaching around. So,
One texter says that his job has made his dong smaller.
Whoa.
From rubbing against the counter standing at the register all day.
That's really weird. You should get a lower chair. Let's talk to who's been holding here for a little bit. Where's our buddy Chris, the plumber? What's up, man?
Hey, what's up, guys? What's up? This is Chris the Plumber from Bel Air. Hey,
Chris the Plumber, shout out.
Shout out, master of the pipe, baby.
Yeah. So when I was 15, I went to apprentice school. I'm 42 now. I've been doing plumbing for 27 years. And from being on my knees, and my back, I have arthritis. My doctor says my back looks like I'm about 70-year-old. He said, imagine your knuckles. Yeah. And how swollen an old man's knuckles look. That's what my back looks like. And then I have arthritis in my knees.
Oh, my God. Sir, we got the results back on your neck, your back, your and your crack. And it's all messed up. Thank you for the call, Chris the Plumber. Let's talk to Steven in PA. Steve checking in from up north. What's up?
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hello.
Hey, I'm a welder for 17 years. And I basically look like a heroin junkie with a... with all the scars going up and down my arms.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, yeah.
Aren't you supposed to wear those big, like, heavy leather gloves or something?
Yeah, but they don't, I mean, the sparks, they burn through. They burn through all your clothes, yeah.
You just got burn marks all over your forearm.
Just knowing part, what if that was your job? Like our good friend Steven in PA, hardworking man. Just knowing, it's a guarantee you're getting burned at your job. Guarantee. Yep. God, you're a badass.
We're getting a lot of these, the no hair. My husband has no hair from a little above his ankles down because of his work boots. The hairless ankles.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of guys that wear dress socks have hairless ankles as well. I think, Speaks, do you have hairless ankles? Somebody I know has hairless
yes,
ankles.
Yes, I do.
Yeah,
yes,
he has smooth, infantile
from socks,
ankles.
I think.
So did my father.
Yeah, he's like a Yeti from the mid-shin up beneath that young orphan boy. This is one that I just know from experience. Pro skateboarders, especially guys that ride vert, like the big ramps and like grab the board a lot, their thumbs and fingers, you can't get a fingerprint off of them. They've been sanded to nothing. It's like half callous, but half weird, almost like doll skin. A bunch of guys over at Pastrana's house just had no fingertips.
What?
They were just smooth.
From what?
From gripping the board with that grip tape.
Oh.
They grip the grip tape and just sand their fingertips off.
Oh, my God.
To nothing.
Here's a weird one. I'm an MRI tech, and it has caused short-term memory loss. This is a proven condition from working in the magnetic field for so long.
Oh.
It just zaps your memory.
Oh. What? Pam says 26 years on a concrete floor. In heels, in retail, I have heel spurs and no cartilage in my left knee anymore. Oh, God. Hey, let's get into something maybe mildly psychological here. Let's talk to Melinda, also in PA. We're big in Pennsylvania. What's up, Melinda?
Hi. Good morning, guys.
Hello. Hello, Melinda.
Well, my job is a little bit more emotional. I have been in collections for the past 10 years, and I would say within the last 5, people have gotten really imaginative and nasty with their reasons why they can't pay. So I have to contact at least 300 people a day, and some of the people that I contact, oh, no, they're not in. I'm like, I just talked to you yesterday.
Oh, you know. So this has turned you into what?
Yeah, mentally.
So it's turned me into cynical. I tell you, I have the best comebacks when my husband and I get into a fight. He's got nothing to do but just throw his hands up in the air. You win, and he leaves the room.
Oh, God.
I mean, I can't really say most of them on the air, but they're great.
Oh, well,
so,
I got a question.
Yeah.
Josh got a question for
you. You happy with your husband?
Huh?
Sometimes. Okay. You want to call me later?
Well,
you know, we can talk it out.
Hey. Well, baby. Maybe I will. It's almost my birthday.
Any questions?
About a year. In about a year.
Yeah. You ever been with a Jewish man?
Yes, I have.
He's been circumcised 4 times.
Yes, I have.
Yes.
Sorry.
Oh,
yeah. Got real inappropriate.
I am.
Sorry.
Strike that from
Sorry, Melinda.
Sorry, Melinda.